Hi, I'm Robin, and welcome to the Red Sea Tips and Tricks. Today we'll talk about NOPOX, providing you with the expert tips that will result in a nutrient-controlled tank and happy corals. So, if you're interested in keeping your nitrate and phosphate right where you want them, stay tuned. Dosing. How much and how often? Your average daily dose depends on your tank type and can be found in the NOPOX manual. In general, SPS-dominant tanks require a daily dose of 1 or 2 ml for 100 litres or 25 gallons, while mixed reefs and frank tanks require a daily dose of 2 ml for 100 litres or 25 gallons. For optimal results, we recommend a single dose once a day. Please note, it is vital to test your water for phosphate and nitrate with reliable test kits. Based on the results, either raise or lower the dose, as recommended in our manual. Either way, do not exceed a daily dose of 3 ml per 100 litres or 25 gallons. Which test kit to use? For SPS-dominant tanks, it is best to use a highly sensitive test kit with a nitrate detection level of 0.25 ppm as provided by Red Sea's Nitrate Pro test kit. If you keep a mixed reef tank, you can use a slightly less sensitive test kit with a nitrate detection limit of 2 ppm as provided by Red Sea's regular nitrate test kit. What to do if the phosphate is not dropping? It takes longer for the phosphate level to go down since hidden phosphate depositories in the live rock are released whenever phosphate is removed from the water column. It may even take 3 to 4 months until all the nutrients are stripped from the rocks and your levels start dropping. If several months have passed and your phosphate level is still not dropping, check the following. 1. Frozen food, for example, is rich in phosphate, so it is important to rinse it before use. 2. Verify that your protein skimmer is indeed strong enough to fully handle your tank's organic load. And 3, your water source could be contaminated. Test your RO water and, if necessary, use a DI filter with your RO membrane. Is NOPOX safe to use with a dosing pump? Yes, and it's even encouraged. But make sure that the NOPOX bottle is properly closed to prevent evaporation. You may also consider drilling 2 holes in the bottle cap, one for the tubing and another one for a non-return valve to prevent the growing vacuum inside the bottle. If your required dosage is too small for your dosing pump, you may dilute the NOPOX with RO water. Use a ratio of anywhere from 1 to 5 parts RO water to 1 part of NOPOX, which will allow you to dose smaller concentrations. When to start using NOPOX in a new tank? Right from the beginning. It's never too early to control your nitrate and phosphate levels, even during the maturing process. This way, your corals and their zooxanthellae algae can hit the ground running. Is a protein skimmer a must? Absolutely. NOPOX reduces phosphate levels by enhancing the activity of phosphate-harboring bacteria. When the bacterial population grows, bacterial flocks are released into the water column and removed from the system by the skimmer. This means that you simply must have an efficient protein skimmer with an air intake that suits your tank, like the Red Sea Reefer skimmer line. A protein skimmer will also protect the tank's inhabitants in case of an accidental NOPOX overdose. How best to set your protein skimmer? It is best to produce a wet skimmate. This will help your skimmer remove all the phosphate-harboring bacterial flocks from the water before they die and release all that phosphate back into the system. What to pay attention to when using NOPOX? NOPOX or no NOPOX, always keep an eye on your corals. If you see polyp retraction or soft tissue shrinkage for an extended period, we recommend you reduce the NOPOX to a daily dose of 0.25 ml per 100 litres or 25 gallons. If no adverse effects are observed after 7 days, increase the dosage to 0.5 ml per 100 litres or 25 gallons. Continue monitoring your corals, and if everything looks good, increase the dosage in small steps every 7 days. What to do in case of bacterial bloom or slime in the sump? These symptoms are usually the result of overdosing with NOPOX. There's no need to panic, this is just a phase and it will pass. Make sure your skimmer is set to wet skimming and wait it out. Clean the sponges and the media filters in your sump and reduce the NOPOX dose, but do not stop dosing. What to do in case of nuisance algae or a cyano outbreak? Using NOPOX in mature tanks or during the introduction of mature live rocks to a new aquarium may result in the growth of hair algae for a period of 2 to 8 weeks. Again, this is no reason to panic. It is a common phenomenon indicating the formation of a proper denitrification process. During this period, the nitrate and phosphate levels will decline, but some of it will precipitate on the live rock, which will temporarily cause hair algae. Over time, all the nitrate and phosphate will be stripped out of these rocks and the algae will disappear. During this phase, you may also see changes in the skimmate color, but once the rocks have been purged, the skimmate will revert to its normal color. can NOPOX be used with other nitrate and phosphate reduction methods? We do not recommend using NOPOX with other methods such as GFO or refugium, as other methods interfere with the NOPOX's ability to control the nutrient level. When is using NOPOX no longer necessary? NOPOX is always necessary. Your corals need a continuous and controlled low level of nutrients so they can live in a clean and healthy home. That's all for today. Comment below if you have any questions or suggestions. Like and subscribe for more great tips, and it goes without saying, join the Red Sea Owners Group, the largest and most dynamic online community of Red Sea system owners. Thanks for watching.